Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the lecture series on the subject internal combustion engine. This is lecture number 2, so we are going to discuss about the 4-stroke cycle petrol engine. So we recap from the previous lecture. So in the earlier first lecture, we studied about the engine components, engine terminologies and engine classification. We studied about the intake manifold, intake valve, exhaust manifold, exhaust valve, spark plug, fuel injector, cylinder, bore, connecting rod, piston, everything. And here we will be studying about 4-stroke cycle petrol engine. The topics are the working principle of 4-stroke cycle petrol engine, theoretical and actual PV diagram of a 4-stroke cycle petrol engine, and the valve timing diagram of the 4-stroke cycle petrol engine. The learning outcome for this lecture, the student will be able to discuss the working of 4-stroke cycle petrol engine, distinguish between theoretical and actual PV diagrams, and draw the theoretical and actual valve timing diagrams. And the student will be able to define the valve overlap and write its significance of the valve overlap. You take few seconds time and look at the video. So there is a piston, inlet valve, exhaust valve, cylinder, crank web, connecting rod, crankshaft, everything, all the components of 4-stroke cycle, spark ignition engine or petrol engine. Number 1 is the upward movement of the piston, and there is a spark, and 3 is the downward movement of the piston, and 4 is the again upward movement of the piston. Look at here, first the intake valve opens, the fresh air fuel mixture blue color is entering. Both the valves are closed and it is getting compressed. Spark is produced, combustion is taking place and going downward, power is produced, and the exhaust valve opens and the burnt gases are let to the atmosphere. So there are 2 revolutions of the crankshaft, 4 strokes, 2 upward movement of the piston, 2 downward movement of the piston, that is 4 strokes, and all the operations are completed. So this is the 4-stroke cycle petrol or spark ignition engine. And look at the detailed diagram. So this is the intake process, intake stroke, this is the compression stroke, this is the power stroke or the expansion stroke, and this is the exhaust stroke. And what is happening in the intake stroke? The piston, it is moving from the, so intake valve is open, the air fuel mixture from the carburetor is entering into the engine cylinder because of the pressure difference, and the piston is moving downward. So this is the intake stroke. Compression stroke, look at the valve position, both the valves are closed, piston is moving in the upward direction from the bottom dead center to the top dead center, and here the air fuel mixture is getting compressed. At the end of the compression stroke, a spark is produced. So using the spark, the combustion of the fuel is taking place and the gases are expanding. So at, because of the combustion, the pressure and temperature of the gas is increasing, the piston is moving downwards. So the force is acting on the top of the piston, which pushes the piston towards the bottom dead center. So piston is moving downward, and in the exhaust stroke, again the piston is moving in the upward stroke, upward direction, the exhaust valve opens and the burnt gases are let to the atmosphere. So these are all the 4 strokes of the 4-stroke cycle spark ignition engine or petrol engine. And the 4 strokes, so suction stroke, compression stroke, expansion stroke and the exhaust stroke, we have the, just by a simple table we can explain the working of the 4-stroke cycle SI engine or the petrol engine, suction valve position, exhaust valve position, piston movement and what is the process taking place. So suction stroke, suction valve opens, exhaust valve is closed and the piston is moving from the top dead center to the bottom dead center. The air-fuel mixture from the carburetor is drawn into the engine cylinder due to the pressure difference. As the piston moving downward, the pressure inside the cylinder will be lower than the atmospheric pressure. So, because of the pressure difference, the air-fuel mixture is drawn into the engine cylinder. The second stroke is the compression stroke. The piston suction valve is closed, exhaust valve is closed, both the valves are closed. The piston is moving from the bottom dead center to the top dead center. The air-fuel mixture is compressed to a higher pressure. So, this is compression. So, work is given from the outside, from the crankshaft. The spark is produced at the end of the stroke using a spark plug, and the combustion begins. And expansion stroke or power stroke. So, both the valves are closed once again. The piston is moving from the top dead center to the bottom dead center. The hot gases produced by combustion expands in the engine cylinder and the power is produced. That is what the expansion stroke or the power stroke. And finally, exhaust stroke. The suction valve is closed and the exhaust valve opens. The piston is moving from the bottom dead center to the top dead center. The burnt gases are led to the atmosphere due to the pressure difference. Now, the pressure inside the cylinder is more than the pressure of the atmosphere. So, because of the pressure difference and the piston movement, the burnt gas led to the atmosphere, and once again the suction stroke. Now, at the end of the exhaust stroke, the piston is at the top dead center, and the next cycle begins starting with the suction stroke. So, these are all the four strokes in the four stroke cycle petrol engine or four stroke cycle SI engine. And now we discuss the theoretical and actual PV diagram of four stroke auto cycle engine. So, auto cycle is the closed cycle, whereas the engine is open system. So, here we start actually in the theoretical auto cycle, there is no suction and exhaust. So, we have four processes: compression, heat addition, expansion, and heat rejection. Now, here practically there are two additional processes, right? So, 1 to 2, 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and 4 to 5. So, this is what your auto cycle, and the horizontal line is added. So, horizontal line you can read like 0 to 1 and 5 to 0. So, now 0 to 1, it is a suction process. So, when the piston is moving from the top dead center to the bottom dead center, so the air is drawn inside at constant pressure. Then 1 to 2, it is compression. So, both valves are closed, piston is moving from the bottom dead center to the top dead center, and all the air fuel mixture is compressed to the clearance space. So, here is spark is produced and the burning and heat addition is taking place at constant volume. So, it is constant volume combustion. Petrol engine, constant volume combustion. So, 2 to 3 is combustion process at the constant volume, and 3 to 4 is expansion. 3 to 4 is expansion and power is produced. So, here now 4 to 5 is called as blowdown. So, here when the piston is at the position 4, the exhaust valve opens. When the exhaust valve opens, suddenly there is a pressure drop. So, from 4 to 5, there is a sudden pressure drop. That pressure drop is called as blowdown process. And when the piston is at the position 5, then the piston is moving from the bottom dead center to the top dead center, and the burnt gas are led to the atmosphere. So, the piston comes to the bottom top dead center once again, and the cycle is repeated. So, this is the theoretical PV diagram of auto cycle engine or petrol engine. But practically, we cannot exactly open the valve exactly at the top dead center, or without any pressure difference, we cannot admit the air fuel mixture or send out the burnt gases. So, there is deviation from the theoretical PV diagram, and the actual PV diagram of the petrol engine, it looks like this. So, for four stroke cycle petrol engine or auto cycle engine, this is the actual PV diagram, and this PV diagram is drawn by a instrument called indicator. So, the indicator is attached to the engine cylinder. The measurement, the cylinder pressure is measured by a pressure transducer, pressure sensor. The input pressure value and the crank angle, so the crank rotation, crank count, crank rotation is also counted. So, using the crank rotation and the pressure sensor, we can draw the PV diagram. So, it is very simple. So, starting from A, so the first stroke is the inlet valve opens here. So, the air fuel mixture, the pressure, the this is what the suction process. So from A to actually just sometimes before the top dead center, the inlet valve opens and the burnt gas or exhaust, I mean fresh air fuel mixture is drawn into the engine cylinder. Then when the piston comes to the bottom dead center, from point to here inlet valve closes, then the air is getting compressed. So here the spark is produced and the combustion is taking place. It is not exactly constant volume combustion, so there is slight change in the pressure, and C2D is the combustion process and D2E is the expansion. So the power produced D2E, and then here before it reaches the top dead, bottom dead center, so the exhaust valve opens and this operation is called as blowdown. So the sudden drop in pressure is called as blowdown and the exhaust process is taking place, and here it is again the inlet valve opens. So this is the actual PV diagram, and the piston is reciprocating between bottom dead center and the top dead center. So you find out the deviation. So the suction process, it is constant pressure here, whereas here suction process is taking place lower than the atmospheric pressure. Exhaust process, again it is constant pressure, but the exhaust process, so inside the engine cylinder, the pressure is higher than the atmospheric pressure. So PO is the surrounding pressure or the atmospheric pressure. And the combustion, it is not exactly constant volume combustion, so there is a slight deviation, slight change in the pressure, and here the blowdown is also slight change in the blowdown operation. So this is what the actual PV diagram. So using this PV diagram, you can find out the work done. So the positive loop, so this loop is called as positive loop and this loop is called as negative loop. So here it is, work done is positive and here is work done is negative. So to calculate the net work done, so the positive work minus the negative work, that gives the net work done of the PV diagram. And what are the operations in the six operations here? So 0 to 1 suction. So inlet valve open, exhaust valve close, piston movement TDC to BDC, air fuel mixture is drawn into the engine cylinder at constant pressure. Compression stroke 1 to 2. So both the valves are closed, piston is moving from the bottom dead center to the top dead center, air fuel mixture is compressed isentropically. At the end of the combustion process, an electric spark is produced which initiates the combustion process. So 2 to 3 is the combustion process. The combustion takes place at constant volume. And the 3 to 4 expansion stroke, 3 to 4, both the valves are closed. Piston is moving from the top dead center to the bottom dead center. The hot gases produced by combustion pushes the piston towards the bottom dead center and work is obtained in this stroke. And then blowdown occurs, blowdown 4 to 5 occurs when the exhaust valve opens. Then exhaust stroke 5 to 0, inlet valve is closed, exhaust valve is opened. So the piston is moving from the BDC to TDC. When the exhaust valve opens, the pressure inside the cylinder drops down from 4 to 5. Then the waste gases are exhausted to the atmosphere at constant pressure. So these are all the six operations occurring at four different strokes. This is what the working of petrol engine. And we said the valves, inlet valve is opening, exhaust valve is opening. So inlet valve closes, exhaust valve, all these things. So what is the valve timing diagram of four stroke cycle SI engine? So look at the diagram. So the piston is moving from the TDC to BDC. So you look at the gear starting from here, one revolution, second revolution. So two revolutions. So first stroke, TDC to BDC, second stroke, BDC to TDC, third stroke, TDC to BDC, and fourth stroke, BDC to TDC. So four strokes and two revolutions of the crankshaft. So theoretically, when the piston is at the top dead center, inlet valve opens. So the suction process is taking place. As the piston is moving from the top dead center to the bottom dead center, the suction process is occurring and the piston is, the valve is closed here, inlet valve is closed here. And now look at here, inlet valve is closed, exhaust valve already closed. So now the piston is moving from the bottom dead center to the top dead center, and this operation is called as compression operation. And at the end of the compression, exactly at the TDC, the ignition starts. So the spark is produced and the combustion of the fuel is taking place and the expansion starts. So the piston is moving from the top dead center to the bottom dead center, the expansion occurs. Then when the piston is coming to the bottom dead center, the exhaust valve opens here and the piston is moving from bottom dead center to the top dead center. So the exhaust operation is completed. So the burnt gas are sent to the atmosphere. And once again, the piston reaches the top dead center and the next cycle is started from inlet valve open. So this is how the valve time diagram is drawn, and this is theoretically. This is theoretical diagram. So inlet valve opens exactly at TDC, inlet valve closes exactly at PDC. So practically that is not possible. So the actual PV diagram, actual valve time diagram for four stroke cycle SI engine. So look at here, inlet valve opens before the top dead center. So roughly 15 degrees before the top dead center, the inlet valve opens, and from here the inlet valve opens here, and the suction process is indicated by the green color line, and the inlet valve closes not exactly at the bottom dead center, some 30 degree after the bottom dead center. So here the inlet valve is closed, then the compression is taking place. So compression is taking place, and the spark is not produced exactly at the top dead center. So some 35 degree before the top dead center, and then the combustion is taking place, and once the piston reaches the top dead center, the expansion, red color expansion process is occurring, power stroke is taking place. When the piston is, now again exhaust valve is not opened exactly at the bottom dead center, some 50 degree, maximum of 15 degree before the bottom dead center, and then the exhaust valve opens and the burnt gases are let to the atmosphere, and the exhaust valve is closed only after the top dead center. So the duration of opening of the exhaust valve is more, and duration of opening of the inlet intake valve is also more than the theoretical valve timing diagram. And why there is a deviation? That is the next question. We have to write why there is a deviation. And for inlet valve, so when the valve is not spontaneously opened completely. So the valve actuality mechanism, it is slowly opening the valve. So if you look at the valve actuality mechanism, the cam pushes the valve to open slowly. So when you slowly open, when the opening is small, the amount of air fill mixture drawn inside will be smaller. So practically when the piston reaches the top dead center, the valve should be completely open. So we start earlier. We see that when the piston reaches the top dead center, the valve is completely in the open condition. So say the air fill mixture, maximum amount of air fill mixture will be drawn into the engine cylinder. And once the piston reaches the bottom dead center, it starts to close. The valve starts to close, and it is completely closed only after 30 degree of bottom dead center. So this is after 30 degree. Then the compression takes place, and the spark is produced little early, 35 degree earlier. Why? The spark produces, combustion takes place. So the combustion, it takes some certain time. So for burning the fuel and producing heat, it requires some time. The time is 35 degrees. So once the spark is produced, the combustion starts. So when the piston reaches the top dead center, the temperature will be maximum and the expansion begins, so that we can extract more amount of work from the hot gases. So once the piston, again as usual, when the piston comes to the bottom dead center, the valve should be in complete opening position. So that is why we open the exhaust valve little early, maximum of 50 degree before the bottom dead center. And the waste gases are completely let out to the atmosphere. So the exhaust valve is closed. So again, when the piston reaches the top dead center, the exhaust valve starts to close, but it is completely closed some 20 degree after the top dead center. So this is why there is a deviation of opening and closing of inlet and the exhaust valve. And when you look at the diagram closely, there is a period. Both the exhaust valve and inlet valve are open. So look at here, for the first cycle, the exhaust valve closes 20 degree after the top dead center, whereas the inlet valve opens 15 degree before the top dead center for the next cycle. So there is a valve overlap. So the simultaneous opening of the inlet valve and the exhaust valve is called as valve overlapping, and it is required. We cannot avoid the valve overlap, and it should be optimized. It should be carefully designed, because when you have more overlapping, so the fresh air fuel mixture which is coming into the engine cylinder, that will escape along with the exhaust gases. So that should be avoided. So you have to carefully design the engine for valve overlapping. So that is very important. So this is what the valve timing diagram, theoretical and actual, for four stroke cycle petrol engine. So we stop here. So in the discussion, we studied about the working principle of Foster cycle petrol engine. We studied about the theoretical and actual PV diagram of Foster cycle petrol engine or SI engine. And we studied about the valve timing diagram, again theoretical and actual valve timing diagram of the SI engine. And this valve timing diagram we will be doing, the experimentally you can measure the valve timing of Foster cycle petrol engine in your IC engine laboratory. So by doing an experiment, you can understand it better. And we stop here. So we have a reflection spot. You try to answer the question from the discussion. You read the question. Four operations, namely suction, compression, expansion, exhaust in a Foster cycle are completed in the number of revolutions of the crankshaft equal to 1 revolution, 2 revolutions, 3 revolutions, 4 revolutions. The answer to the question. Quickly. So, if your answer is 2, you are correct. 2 revolutions of the crankshaft and 4 strokes. And 4 operations, namely suction, compression, expansion, exhaust in a Foster cycle are completed in the number of revolutions of camshaft equal to. How many revolutions of the camshaft for completing all the 4 operations, 4 strokes, 4 cycles? So, if your answer is 1, so the camshaft is rotating 1 revolution for 4 strokes. That is why, that is the reason is the camshaft rotates half of the speed of the crankshaft. So, the camshaft and the crankshaft, they are connected by the timing gear. So, the rotation number of revolutions of the camshaft is half of the number of revolutions of the crankshaft. In spark ignition Foster cycle engine, the camshaft runs at twice the speed of the crankshaft, at the same speed of the crankshaft, at half the speed of the crankshaft, at any speed irrespective of the crankshaft speed. The correct answer is C, at half the speed of the crankshaft. So, these are all the answers. And these are all the reference book I use. So, I have published a book on thermal engineering. You can refer to IC engines by Ganesan, IC engines by Gillen Smith, and Fundamentals of IC Engine by John B. Haywood, or Thermal Engineering by Rajput or Bellani for better, more information on this subject. So, thank you for watching, and you please post your comments on the comment box of YouTube video. So, you click the comment box and post your video, post your comment. Subscribe the channel. So, I have published more than 160 video lectures on the thermal engineering subjects, including thermodynamics and heat and mass transfer, and gate solution for the gate questions. So, that will be useful for your better learning. You can write to my mail ID or contact me through WhatsApp. I will sincerely answer all your questions. Thank you very much for listening.